It's a beautiful world. But there's war, war, war. Somewhere on Earth, there must be a key to peace. In the north of Europe, there's a special place where the people know all about peace. A group of islands with a special message for the world. Åland is beautiful, and Åland is different. 6,000 tiny islands in the Baltic Sea between Finland and Sweden. And no soldiers anywhere, nothing military at all. The last real battle in Åland was in 1854, when the fort at Bomersund was destroyed, even before the buildings were finished. And that was 5 years before the Battle of Solferino, that gave Henry Dunant the idea of the Red Cross. 2 years before the Red Cross began, Åland's capital, Mariehamn, was founded in 1861. It's still the only town in the islands, but today, almost half the 23,000 people of Åland live there. Today, through international agreements going back all those years, Åland has become a model for peace. A small corner of the world where armies and navies and air forces are simply not allowed. Åland is a province of Finland, but Åland people speak Swedish and have their own flag, their own stamps, their own parliament, and very much their own traditions. Midsummer is important in the north, where winters are long and dark and cold. Every village in Åland puts up midsummer poles to celebrate the longest day of the year, the sunlight, and all the good things that nature brings in the summer months. People are sea people, fishermen and great sailors who took the biggest sailing ships around the world before the days of steam. Today, the young people of Åland may not all grow up to be sailors, but they are still very proud of their islands of peace in a world where there's so much war.
All together. inte svårt att sjunga.
Singing is not difficult if you're happy and at peace.
Men allt för många människor, allt för
But too many people, too many children like us, can't be so happy because they live in places of disaster and war. Children our age, children who like us will take over running the world if we all survive. Can't all of us do something to stop the madness and all the killing? Harmony? Is it too much to ask for? It's our world after all. But what a state it's in. Bombs, weapons everywhere. More and more money spent on more and more arms. Why not spend it on food and shelter for those who have nothing? On life and health, not on death. Why have nuclear bombs? Which one of us can say, I will survive a nuclear war? You? No. You? No. Any of us?
Nay.
If our world is going to have any future at all, we've got to change things. We've got to say no to war and misery. We've got to make peace on our earth.
Bye.
What wonderful words. But in the end, they're just words. What are we going to do about it? We're going to take over all the children in the world. But when?
Lær til landet med ham.
Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. This world conference convening today comes exactly 9 years after the first World Red Cross Conference on Peace, which took place in Belgrade, Yugoslavia, in 1975. It should have resumed its meetings before now.
Why have so many people from all over the world come to Holland?
Because it's a very peaceful place, and they come from parts of the world, many of them at least, where there is war. So they thought that the best place to talk about peace was to go on a little island which had not only no armies, but also a history of peace through talking with each other.
What's the conference all about?
Well, it's about the Red Cross and Red Crescent movement trying to make a list of all the ways in which it can contribute to peace. If you really want to have a lasting peace, it means that you should have no more hunger, that you should have respect for human rights, that you should have social justice. So it's the building every day through the gestures which the Red Cross do, the humanitarian gestures which the Red Cross do, which we hope may contribute to bringing at least a spirit of peace in the world. And if you have a spirit of peace, then it's much harder to have war.
What's the conference got to do with young people?
Well, I think this is a belief and faith in the future, faith in the youth, faith that the youth can be in a position to follow what the adults are doing and what can be done for the whole human race. And this conference is particularly of significance to the youth, because if these steps are being taken by the family of the Red Cross and Red Crescent Society, it is an indication that if man continues to strive for the best, for the ideal in life, there is a hope in the future. And I think this conference has a lot to say to the youth generally throughout the world.
What do you think this World Conference have to say to us, to young people?
Many things, I think. But the first one should be to hear the young people, to know what the young people and the new generations are thinking about the present world and about the future. It is very important for us, the adults, to know exactly what do you want for yourself, because we try to build up a new world for a new generations, because we believe that the present world is not exactly the best one, and we need to fight in favor to have a more peaceful community, because it should be your community. It should be the heritage for the new generations, and mainly my children, because I have children too. I have many children, I have 7 children. Always I think in them, in their future, in their world. It is the most important message from today. We must be able to know exactly what the new generation want and in what kind of world you want to live today, tomorrow, and after tomorrow.
Distinguished delegates to the Second World Red Cross and Red Crescent Conference on Peace, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor for us that you have chosen the Åland Islands as the site for this important conference. I convey the greetings from the province of Åland to the conference and express my best wishes for the success of its work, a task which is of great importance for the future. The youth of today is our future. The children from Åland share our concern and our hopes for a better future. They will speak for all of us in welcoming you to the Åland Islands.
What we want to say is very simple. Let's get together all around the world. Let's get to know each other. Let's be friends. Is it so very difficult? Try it once, like this. Let's take each other's hands.